So I put this together for you guys and I didn't say much about it. I did have a few questions, so I'm going to put this video out there to give you a better idea and some more specifics about what you're supposed to do here. So we're going to talk about some rhetorical devices which show up in any kind of argumentative writing. You see it a lot in persuasive writing. Those are slightly different things. So we're going to kind of talk about commercials or poems or songs or even speeches and how those use rhetorical devices to get their point across and to make their points and then also to get the audience to go along with their points. So your first slide, and I will not play this video right now, but your first slide is the short version of a Coke commercial. So just over here on the right-hand side, as you go through the commercial, pay attention to the images and then watch the words as they change on the screen. And then also, of course, you have the music. So, and I know that's a lot, so go back. It's a pretty short video. Go back and watch it and listen to it more than one time so you can kind of catch on to what they're doing with the words and then how the music maybe goes along with the images that are on the screen. And then kind of what's being used to see if you can come up with, is it mostly ethos? Is it mostly logos? Is it mostly pathos? So after you do that, then the next slide is the same commercial. It's a longer version of the commercial, but it's actually being analyzed by a person. So you can see what you may not have caught on to. This person is going to kind of explain the words and how those work and how it the whole thing together with the music and the images and the words on the screen help to make you feel like you would like a Coke right now. All right, so then after you go over that, first of all, rhetorical analysis is not a summary. So you're not going to be choosing a commercial or a song or a poem or whatever you decide to choose. You're not going to choose that and then just summarize what it says. Your assignment is to write a rhetorical analysis for any one of the following. So I've already said those things. An editorial might be a little harder. I would stick with either a commercial, a song, a poem, or even a short speech if you can find one. And that can be a video of a speech or a written speech. It's fine. After choosing that item, you can go ahead and forward a copy to me or share a copy on a Google document, or you can just wait until the whole thing is completed and then share it with me. But it's probably easiest to put it on a Google Doc and then just share it with me and put the link to the video or the website. You know, if it's a song or a poem, just stick it on a Google Doc and then share it with me. All right, so once you move on, once you decide on your text, you will decide if it uses pathos, logos, ethos, or a combination of those. A combination is very likely, but you might be really heavy on one or the other. So then you're going to list the rhetorical devices that are used in the text. And I put text in quotes because, you know, it's a commercial, maybe, but it's also a text. It's a song, but it's also a text. If you go to this slide, this is just some videos that kind of show you, first of all, how to be persuasive and use rhetorical devices. There's some lyrics from a Tupac song, and they're analyzed for their rhetorical devices. If you look at the literary devices list here, that's just a website, examples and definitions, good for songs. So, you know, whichever one you decide to use, you can just kind of click on those and look through them and get some ideas of what you could say about your chosen text. All right, so you're going to write down what overall rhetorical device are being used, or, you know, type up just in your notes somewhere. And then you need to, once you decide whether it's logos, pathos, or ethos, you're going to come up with specific rhetorical devices. So, and I'll explain that in just a second. It's easiest to explain it with my own example, and we'll get there in just a minute. So, what you're going to do is write an analysis that explains how all these pieces work together to create a message for the audience. So, number four on this slide just gives you what your writing is going to consist of. So you're going to have your topic sentence, you're going to introduce what your text uses, then you're going to introduce the individual rhetorical devices, explain the first device, explain the second one, and then kind of explain how it all comes together and put a little concluding sentence in there. So on the next slide is a color-coded example. The due date's not there. This is an assignment that I use quite often, actually. So your due date is, of course, the end of this week. All right, so here's my example. I chose an Apple iPhone Christmas commercial, which was from 2013, and I'm just letting you know that the word count is 246 and it contains 11 sentences. So that 5 to 6 or 4 to 5 sentence paragraph that you've always heard about is not probably going to work here. So for the topic sentence, I've just said this commercial relies almost completely on the rhetorical device of pathos by tugging at the viewer's heartstrings. So we all know that pathos is to do with emotions. So right now, you don't know what emotion it is, but when you tug at viewers' heartstrings, you're making them feel emotional about something like, oh, isn't that sweet? Maybe there are some tears of joy. Maybe it's so happy that you want to cry. I don't know, something like that. All right, so how does it do this? It chooses or it uses imagery and irony. So I just chose two very specific literary devices. So my overall device is pathos, but my specific devices are imagery and irony. And that is in that second kind of pink or whatever color sentence that is. In the green, I'm just giving you an explanation of the imagery and explaining what the imagery in the commercial is, and then why it works. So this one, there happens to be a snowy neighborhood and kids sledding, a family preparing dinner together. Remember, this is a Christmas commercial. This is leading up to Christmas. So that's what it's going to be about. And then as an audience, we kind of look at this commercial and we remember our own great experiences with our family at Christmas and all that. Okay, so then irony is the next one that I need to explain, and that one is the blue. The irony is what makes the audience surprised at the end. It causes emotion, unexpected kind of emotions like, oh, isn't that sweet? But we're watching a teenager who seems very disconnected from everyone else because of his phone. And then it's like, oh, okay, he was doing something that we didn't expect. And that kind of tugs at our emotions even more. And it ends up being very sweet. And I haven't linked my commercial, but I guess now that I'm thinking about it, I can link it on here so you can see exactly what it is. So because the audience is supposed to be an adult audience, these are the people who are purchasing the iPhones. There's a reason all of this works, the nostalgia and the family and the Christmas and the teenagers and all of that. So I just kind of wrapped it up how it all comes together with one sentence at the end. All right, and then there's just a speech at the end that you can watch once you're all finished. But that is the main, going backwards now, that's the main thing. You don't have technically a length, but like I said, mine was almost 250 words and it's very descriptive, explains everything. Don't be afraid to be specific and explain how everything works. If you're talking about music, what kind is it? What rhetorical devices are used? Is there repetition? How does that, I mean, in most songs there is repetition. That would probably be one of your devices that you would want to talk about. How that works, what's being repeated, how is that working for the audience, how does that work for the message. So anything you want to do, and then of course if you have a question about it, you can always send me a link to the commercial and I could watch it real quick, or the poem or the speech or whatever, and I could look over it really quickly and maybe give you some ideas if you're stuck somewhere. But that's it. All right, let me know if you have any questions throughout the rest of the week. Thanks, guys.